You don't do it. Okay.
Okay, sir. According to the Nigerian Association of Robotics and Prosthetics, in 2015, the device is seen as a device that is temporarily immobilized.
Okay, so the same massage, the use of the hands on the body too.
I'm very sure we've been enjoying it. Permit me to stand on the existing protocol. This afternoon, I'm meant to talk about the involvement of the Department of Physiotherapy and the academic members of staff's participation in the university life. There is a proverb in the United States of America. It's been read that in various ways. Some will relate it to children, some will relate it to girls, some will relate it to women. Using the case of children, they will say, children are meant to be seen and not to be heard. But there is a lady that made a reference to that popular proverb, and when she was going to say it, she said, my mom used to tell me that girls should be seen and not be heard. But I say they should be seen and feared. And I'm glad to tell us that the Department of Physiotherapy, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, evolved from the old state of being seen and not heard to a level when the department today is not just seen, but is greatly acknowledged within the community of the University of Ibadan. We've all heard of the evolution of the training program when we had to hide, you know, students in cubicles to teach and things like that. And the department was hardly to be reckoned with. But today, the department is in a state where, when things are to happen, either in the College of Medicine or in the University of Ibadan, people find out if you've been to physiotherapy department. Have you spoken to them in the physiotherapy department? Have you secured the support of the physiotherapy department? And that did not happen overnight. But through the involvement of the faculty members in the department over the years, when we look at the university community, there are several aspects of the university life. We have the academic life of the university. We have the community life of the university. And when we look at the community life of the university, there are various dimensions to it again. There is the welfare, there is the housing, there is the security, that there is the social or the ceremonials. And I want to tell us that academic staff members in the physiotherapy department have been involved in all of these areas to the point that they have become a force to reckon with. Let me say that in the past, when people have been appointed to positions, they will hardly remember physiotherapy. But over the years, this has changed. Sometime in the early 2000s, in the Faculty of Clinical Sciences, the need to have a subdean that will specially serve the nursing and physiotherapy programs was muted. And this originated from the physiotherapy training program. And that was the time the Faculty of Clinical Sciences began to have more than one subdean. We then had subdean MBBS, and then we had subdean nursing and physiotherapy program. And over the years, various members, several members of the department have served in that capacity. Our current head of the department served as a subdean undergraduate nursing and physiotherapy between 2002 and 2004. Dr. Ayoni served in that capacity between 2006 and 2010. Dr. Adeniyi served in that capacity between 2012 and 2014. Apart from serving at such level, we have the central academic life of the university being overseen by the Senate, the University Senate. There was a time when even the head of the training program was not a full-fledged member of the Senate, but only invited to a Senate meeting when issues concerning the department would have to be discussed, because statutorily he was not a member of Senate. But the department had evolved from such a humble beginning to a time when statutorily we had three members of the Senate and we had other academic members of staff elected into the Senate. And among such elected members of the Senate, we had Dr. Ayoni, we had Dr. Adeni, we had Dr. Ubiki, we had Dr. Akere. So these were elected members of Senate, apart from the statutory members. That's to what extent the department had been involved in the university life. Still talking about the university life, there was a time when physiotherapy students will have to complain here and there because of accommodation issues and so on. But we have it on record now that several members of the academic youth staff had served in the housing committees of the university, beginning from Professor Arimla Smyer. She has served in the university housing committee for several years. And apart from such service, today we have members of the department that are officers of halls of residence within the university. Our own Professor T.K. Hamzat is the current hall master of Alexander Brown Hall. Our own Dr. Gumine is an assistant warden of the Alexander Brown Hall. Our own Dr. Adeniyi is an assistant warden of Teja Hall. Now, apart from having our academic staff members serve as subdean at undergraduate level, Professor T.K. Hamzat had also served as the subdean postgraduate of the Faculty of Clinical Sciences. Now, apart from all this, we have also had the privilege where one of our own in physiotherapy rose to the level of the number two person in the university community, the Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration. And that is in person of Professor Ariola Soya. Now, talking about other activities within the College of Medicine, the Ibadan College of Medicine Alumni Association. At inception, Dr. Sonny Hill was Secretary General of the Ibadan Worldwide. After him, Dr. Henry had served, I think, as Financial Secretary of the Ibadan Worldwide. The current Secretary General of Ibadan Worldwide is our own Dr. Adeniyi. Now, even at the university level, centrally, the current university orator is no other person than our own Professor T.K. Hamzat. And when you look at such an appointment, you know that it is a rare one. In fact, I overheard some comments where is it Department of Linguistics or whatever? They think it is a natural position for their faculty and department. And Physiotherapy broke the jinx. There is this university that possesses two of you much in print for a little for the moment. You know, nobody would have thought that the distributing the portions of the feed or the pork, then it is the pie that will be the portion of the chief imam. But you see, that's exactly what has happened. Nobody will imagine that they are appointing a master orator, and it will come from the faculty of arts. And then suddenly, it is to the Department of Physiotherapy, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan. And in the political life of the College of Medicine, the university, or even locally as a faculty, the Department of Physiotherapy is a force to reckon with. I can remember as far back as the time of the contest between Professor Shogunmi and Professor Shogunli as provost of the College of Medicine there. Some of us in the Department of Physiotherapy were in the campaign team that did the legwork for the election. When it was the turn of Professor Adewale to be dean of the faculty, some of us in the department were in the campaign team. When it was to be provost College of Medicine, some of us in the department were in the campaign team. And up until today, we all know that he remains a very close friend of the Physiotherapy Department. That's how relevant our department has become in the life of the university community. And that is from such a very humble beginning. We want to give all the glory to God for granting us such relevance in the community life of the university. Thank you.
The rod of energy to them. They want to take over. And I said,
First, you know that you want to kill all your leaders. That those who that tried it in the past, they regretted it. There is always a place for them and always learn from history. That is one of the reasons why we have this item, so that you can see where we started and what it took us to get here. Now, having said that, then it is your responsibility to take us to the next level. We have worked hard to get to where we are. The next 50 years, many of us in this room, if you are still around, we come like Baba, Baba Shu. We'll be here to celebrate with you. But we'll be glad to see where we have taken this department to in the next 50 years. I want to seize this opportunity to recognize the president of the NSP, Mr. Oyewumi Taiwo, is sitting in the house. I saw him came in a few minutes ago. Mr. Taiwo, the comrade, Felix, Panama. You are welcome. Thank you very much. Now, talking about student being activists, Mr. Panama has been very active in NSP, even as a student. So it's natural. So when Mr. Panama became NSP president, he was quite young. It's not like people that are saying they want to snatch leadership of NSP. You work for it. When you work for it, you get it. If I imagine somebody who has never been part of NSP, even in the hospital charter, or hospital, I don't know what they call the hospital or something, at hospital level, now want to be president at the center. It's not going to happen. Some of you want the delegate system, and I keep telling them, the delegate system was introduced because of certain problems. If we're not going to do that. Mr. Panama, we appreciate your contribution to this. Thank you for coming. I want to introduce my colleague to come and make our presentation, Dr. Omoyemi Okokumi.
Good afternoon, everyone. I wish to stand on the existing protocol, and the task I have is a very simple one. Department of Physiotherapy. Actually, from the history from my senior colleagues, we all got to know that this program started in 1997, and since it is an 18-month program, in 1998-1999, some of us that were here earlier part of the day listened to Dr. Ebi when he was giving his presentation. And from that presentation, we got to know that there were some individuals that actually started with the NPL PAD program, while some started with the NSC program. So he gave us some reasons why, one way or the other, some people could not complete the NSC program at that time, such that we just had five people completing the NSC program. Really, we shouldn't forget the fact that individuals that started with NPL AP program have started with other programs, with the NSC program in other departments, maybe anatomy, maybe physiology, pharmacology, and then they have to stay more additional number of years to obtain the PAP program. Toward the end of this presentation, I made an outline of the Palmyra program. The Palmyra people that had the PAP first, as I put them, fourth generation, second generation, and so on. But what I basically have here are the MSc candidates, the individuals that are able to complete the MSc in the first instance. I don't have their pictures. I just went into the departmental archives and got the numbers. This is what we have for 1999 session. Then subsequently, the 2000 and 2001 session, we have them. These were the the individuals that completed the program, and I'm sorry, I must let you know that the MSc program is normally classified in three categories, three or four now. People, individuals are, that pass through the program, they have to proceed to the PhD level. Some have to proceed to the MSc PhD level and field. Some may have terminal masters. In that way, the individuals cannot continue in the academia. And maybe they have to continue as clinicians, you know, if you want to go into business, accounting, things like that. Then some, after a while, we noticed that some individuals are not able to complete the program as distributed time by the PG school. So those are not that have a complete job. And here, this was the total number of candidates that actually finished the program. So for 2000 and 2001, anyone with terminal master or anyone with incomplete results, and this was the five people that actually completed that time. 2001-2002 session, practically all the candidates had MPhil, two of them, they were proceeding to MPhil level, one MPhil, then this is the total for the candidates, that is three individuals. Then for 2003 session, we have four candidates who are to proceed to the PhD. One, M2 PhD, two, MPhil, and this is the total, seven. For 2004 session, we have four candidates. We had four candidates that was proceed to PhD, MPhil PhD, three candidates, MPhil, one candidate. Here we started having one individual with a terminal master, and then nine of them involved. We can see that more candidates are making do with the program. From 2004-2005 session, we can see now that we have my chart in different categories. If you remember when Dr. Debbie was presenting the one, he told us that we had majorly candidates that applied for sports, orthopedics, and recreational physiotherapy. But at this level, we can see that we have candidates for neurological physiotherapy, as well as orthopedic and sports and recreational physiotherapy. And here, we can see that in this session, 2005, we have four candidates that were proceed to a PhD, five in PhD in neurological physiotherapy, five orthopedic and sports. Then we had, you know, different categories of people that were actually making a lot of efforts. So that gives us the total. Same for 2005-2006. You can see the breakdown here. We have a number of candidates with incomplete results. And well, I was not there for happy, but a number of people, students with incomplete results, they were not able to cope. Some had challenges at their workplaces. We know some physiotherapy organs may not find so easy, you know, managing the clinic in the absence of some of these young people. So some of them are not able to really concentrate. And some will actually not take the challenge, they will not take it so seriously, because really, it's a lot of effort. Some of them will be impacted for what they actually meant from the program. This gives us breakdown for 2007-2008. We have almost the same number of candidates in neurological physiotherapy and orthopedics and sports physiotherapy proceeding to PhD level. Some here we have just two candidates proceeding to the end of PhD level. We have one candidate MPhil, no terminal master candidate, three incomplete results candidates, and results total. 2008-2009. Here, the candidates could not complete the program and stipulated the period by the teacher school. I know this would have been maybe because of some industrial action, because it's just not possible for us to have a certain number of students and they will not be able to complete their program if there is no original reason. 2009-2010, we had three people that used to complete the program for orthopedics and sports, two neurological physiotherapy. The number of them, three of them, was to proceed to M2 PhD, M2 and this male terminal masters. Some also had incomplete results here. From 2010-2011, 3 candidates were able to proceed to PhD level, male M2 PhD, field 1 and 2 respectively, MPhil in the neuro and orthopedic specialty areas. 1 incomplete results and that is the total. 2011-2012, we see neurological physiotherapy, quite a number of why to proceed to the PhD level. 1 PhD and so on. 2012-2013, care is like we have the things still broken because the primary physiotherapy actually in the project has 3 specialty areas. We have the cardiorespiratory physiotherapy, the orthopedic sport and occupational physiotherapy, and then but you notice that in the past years, we were not having candidates for cardiorespiratory physiotherapy. But here, you see that the panel was able to graduate 1 candidate in the cardiorespiratory physiotherapy specialty. You know? So the panel was supposed to proceed to the PhD level. This candidate was actually came in at the MPhil PhD level, and he was able to complete the and we proceed in this year and we're able to push back here. So we also see here another candidate here and then that is all the total. It means we actually have 2 for that session. Then for the 2013-2014 session, you can see the breakdown for neuro, sport and orthopedics. Then these are the candidates that were able to proceed. And since then, we have actually been having candidates in cardiorespiratory physiotherapy specialty. Now, this just gives us an overall breakdown or outlook of the candidates, you know, how they perform. You can notice that from 1998 to 1992 to 2004, most of the candidates were in the just one specialty area. Special 1 or 2 was here, you can see that we have a new and latter part of 2013, the cardiorespiratory specialty area actually came up. And I would like to let you know that we have quite a number of PhD graduates now. And as I put here, so it may not really be how my senior colleagues look at it. We have quite a number of our senior people that were able to strong hard and were able to have PhD completed, you know. And we have the first generation of Professor T.K. and that, I guess, in 2001. Professor Dr. Fiona Ayoki, I know you a professor, Professor Dr. Shoshana Shola, and Winnie. You know, this attracted a lot. Very hard, and I believe that we are able to make it. So we have quite a number of the others. You know, people I put as second generation, Dr. Shola Odele, Dr. A.F. Adeyemi, Dr. T. Odebiyi, my very own self, Dr. Tela. So we have a number of other people that have actually achieved this feat. You can see this set of people that look like numbers. Johnson, he was one of the people that presented yesterday. Dr. Olaleye, Dr. Olafa, Dr. Manola, Dr. Grace Olobadi, Dr. Kuitebe, Ake Chinobedo, Dr. Musalimo, Dr. Shuli Mbada. The way I put it here now, actually, how the finish was.
Outside our peace. Now, maybe you are not the foreign level, you are meant to start we go to emphasis physiotherapy, we go to keep tone and interact sense and exchange. And we also go to launch physiotherapy. Now trying to speak to the face. The number one problem is accommodation. Now I still when you experience something, you don't have to tell what you experience better. You know, what we experienced there, like I and my classmates, was hell. Trying to get where to just stay for the time being. You know, there is no accommodation for us. School does not provide. You are left on your own. OYO on your own. You know, you feed for you, you feed yourself, you transfer yourself, you look for where to rest your head at night. You know, so you are all by yourself. I don't think it is too good for students. And again, because the teeth fair is so killing. You know, there was intra competition or intra networking. That's too expensive. Now the rest of you, all I can do is ask the rest of you. There is no break. Immediately you have done before them, and then you go back to start immediately. There is no rest of you, of course. You know, and then we are meant to, when we are meant to just resume our reports at our place of duty. And immediately you are running up, we are running up on what you are doing in the community charity center or something. You set your running up. That there is no time to rest, you are commencing training immediately, you are going back to your class, and there are plenty of knowledge of students. So we really wish we can have a position. And I think a position is not being too big for the University of Ibadan to provide those things. Mind you, we have other institutions of plenty, like doing a lab, the lab there. But the school can arrange between the lab to make sure that students have a position at least. I think that The only joy we derive is joy relating with people of children special needs. You can see we had our own quite a Valentine celebration for children special needs. You can see my classmates dancing out there and we and some of the children. Now for all the children and clinical students. Normally not in 4-year level, second semester. Now, the lecturers are always there, as always. To all the difficult issues and everything, every question we have, they are always the ability to answer. Now, this student will be graded by lecturers individually, and I tell you, it's never a chance for me. Now, projects. The project commences in 500 level. The project proposal will be presented individually for putting. After the student will continue with the research process of our proposal, if approved. Now, project design is something every single student cannot wait to get on with. My opinion, I want to also give to the department for allowing the mentors of students to be their supervisors. I think I want to think about the mentor is someone that can share the things. Now, examination as usual is not quite students. School suit, but the exam is for you. Now, let me talk about this for the exam. You can bet that I have the fact that we always hold a pre-exam meeting with all students to pay us for exam. It lasts for just a week. Clinical exams are done only in second semesters. Now the challenge is, like I said, it's just not for a week. It's very alarming. You can imagine the rush, the frustration, the stress, the conflict for you to complete 9 exams in just 1 week. There are no clinical for rest. Now, induction, the serious business in the department. Only certified finalists are involved. Others will have to finish up the department's requirements before leaving the department. The graduates are the focus of the day. Now, the setup we have in induction, and I think we should partner with it. I suggest that. Okay, the department only recommends the best for the students. What about awarding the second and third? What about best research work? What about the best in clinical practice? And this is endless. Now, in conclusion, my department here is honorably the best place to train as a physical student. My lecturers are chefs, mentors, standard models, friends, and professionals. My clinicians are awesome and gifted with healing hands. My colleagues are wonderful, motivated, cooperative, and diligent people. My alumni, though you are practically forgotten us, both of you are still very much proud of you. One way option. Thank you. I'm coming to you.
some adoption problem without being part and parcel of the political hierarchy of the institution. And I'm sure we must play the politics of how to distribute the properties. We are living for the industry, and we also need to be part of that system to be able to take a decision on how it is done. And I believe that we should go there. Now, I listened to Dr. Kumike, and I was curious why she talked about the number of PhD people were produced. I want to challenge the College of Medicine of Ibadan. You are the leaders in the physiotherapy program. You must produce, you must live up to your mission. I read the mission statement of the institution. To produce physical therapists with high clinical competence. Have you been able to identify and get feedback that all your products are they particularly also giving you enough and adequate clinical outcomes? That should be feedback now. Because now we are producing a book, what are we getting from the field? Are they performing to your expectation? This is the time to have standards and to work with the social association to ensure that all our products are being up to date. I want to congratulate you on this great occasion. I'm extremely proud to be associated with this institution. Finally, on the issue of alumni, this is the payback time. Those of us who have been trained, this is the time for us to feel proud to give back to our alumni. And so I want to please encourage all those who have passed out of this institution. And I think I want to use those who are too as part of contact. Let us organize a formidable alumni association and ensure that annually we meet. They must have projects to undertake and assist the institution in achieving the goals. This is the time to pay back to the institution that made us. And I want to say thank you to all our teachers and to our younger colleagues. Please, you must take a decision today that we mark the anniversary. What can I do to improve this institution and this profession? Not what can I get, but what can I do? What can I contribute? As you do so, I want to assure you that you shall be happy. This is the profession of the moment. And in America now, it has been raised to the level of what they call the doctoring profession. And physical therapists now are at par with their counterparts in general medicine and surgery. And they are doctors in practice. And it is due to the quality of training here that we are getting to that position. Let us keep it up. Let us improve it. For our teachers, thank you very much. God bless you.
Another round of applause for former president of NSU. Yes, we are still waiting for more contribution from the club. More contribution from the club, please. Yes.
Then out to get in contact with them, then we'll be able to achieve some of these things.
and who we are seeing when we are back in 50 years' time, we are still in the same place. Thank you very much.
Contribution. Unfortunately, I think we are trying that. When we started the alumni association, that was the approach that we took. Because actually we wanted to see with that you know your classmates. And most of the time, some of these things are better done set by set. So we went that way. Unfortunately, it hasn't given. People were submitting the names of their people they are set and things like that. Reverend, I mean, we tried that, but we haven't. But unfortunately, we have not got the desired result. I said it in the morning, and I don't know the problem because as Physiotherapists, we are not as poor as we tend to forget ourselves. We are not even poor, but we find it difficult to be. But I read the reports of previous leaders. Their reason was that we could have started in apps, but there was no money. We could have started in apps, but there was no money. So I read the report and said, oh, this time we will have it. I was an independent student, but I made up my mind and we are going to have it. We called a meeting, got the view of our lecturer, the board, and we had the first meeting. We committed our own money initially to it. In fact, as poor as I was then, my bursary award, I used it to motivate the formation of maps. And once we had the first meeting, we had them, that was Lagos, then we had another program for IFE. That was where we had the first national meeting. And it was a great success. From there, it's took off. So the same thing will happen. These people are people taking something from this institution, and they cannot find that they finished here. So I want to beg you, sir. And since we have you, I'm happy. I didn't train here, but I want to train here. Maybe I'll go and do a PhD. But I want to assure you that I said the same thing at Lagos. Right before that night, I challenged our colleagues and said, they should have used the Papaudia there to form a formidable alumni association. So we should start it. Physiotherapy needs that at this time. Don't let us be distracted by those who are not going to encourage us, but by you, orderly. And these are who are interested. That's how we do our investing. And we lost others to come. Thank you very much.
I have just a little contribution. I just want to encourage us that anytime we have an event, we should make good use of it for publicity purposes. Like this occasion, it's a very big one, but I'm not encouraged about the publicity. I don't think we did enough of it. There was no poster to the effect. So that is where, if we have posters nationwide, I think we'll get more people. And if we actually contacted institutions, if we contact institutions individually, because I had the course of HODs, and I was surprised to hear that they did not get an invitation officially, then that actually affected the turnout. If I'm sure in Enugu we didn't get anything. It was even last week I was mentioning to some people, and they're very surprised. So it's this type of avenue that we need. Any opportunity we have at the institution, let people know, publicize it very well. That's when we get crowd, and from that, we get people that are committed, and then the alumni will grow well.
Thank you very much. So publicity, so you are saying the publicity was not good enough. But you said poster, I'm sure that's the way I see it. Is there any other confusion from the floor, please? Because,
This dinner, I can see the beautiful colors, the ambience of this place, the lightning and the beautiful faces seated before me. I want to welcome you all. I strongly believe it's going to be a
The microphone eventually commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Department of Physiotherapy, University of Ibadan. My name is Fatai Adini, and this night I will co-MC this program with this beautiful young lady,
Dr. Lubukola Palale.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome. The first item here is the anthems, but I think to play safe, we'll just do the national anthem. Please, let's rise and sing the national anthem together.
Arise, O compatriots, Nigerians, call obey to serve the Fatherland with love and strength and faith. The labor that heroes pass shall never be in vain. To serve without a mind, one nation bounding freedom, peace and unity.
Thank you very much. That was a wonderful rendition. The first person I'm going to call on to the high table, and I have to the chairman of this very important program for tonight, and that person is a friend of the department. In this hall tonight,